Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over a couple of different options for using a loop in VBA code in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I am in Excel, and I would like to access my VBA code window. And I have a few options of how I can do this. If I hit Alt F11, I will be taken to the VBA or Visual Basic for Applications coding window. Now, once I'm in here, if I go up to Insert, I can insert what's known as a module. So go ahead and click that option under the Insert menu. And now, if I would like to write a loop, I can do this by starting a new sub-procedure. So I'm going to type the word sub with a space, and then I'm going to write the name of my subroutine. And this can be anything you want it to be. So we're just going to call it insert serial numbers, and then hit enter. And notice two things here after I hit enter. First, two parentheses have been put here. That's because subroutines can take arguments if you would like them to. In our case, we're not going to do that, but that's why those two parentheses get put there. Also, this line called nsub has been put here as well. And that's just to let Excel know when the subroutine is going to end. So I like to hit tab and indent my code between the sub and the nsub just because it looks a little bit neater. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to declare a variable. What does that mean? Creating a variable is a way to store a value inside of your code from the beginning of the time that your code runs until the end. And that variable may or may not change from beginning to end. So hopefully when I'm done writing this routine for you, you'll have a little better idea of what a variable is. So right here, I'm going to type dim because that's a Microsoft Excel reserved word for declaring a variable. So I'm going to type dim I as, and you can see I have a whole list of things that come up here. This list contains different options that I have for the type of this variable. And in our case, I want to call this a variable an integer because I'm going to be numbering from 1 to 10. Okay, so now once I have my variable, what am I going to do with it? I am going to write a for next loop. And it goes like this. For I equals 1 to 10, and then I'm going to hit enter. So what this means is I'm going to keep doing something 10 times from the time that I equals 1 until the time that I equals 10. So what am I going to do? Let's say we're going to take each row inside of Microsoft Excel, and we are going to number that 1 to 10. So let's say cells with a left parenthesis, and my first argument is asking me for the row. Well, I want the row to keep changing based on what I is. So I'm going to type I and then comma, and then my column, I would like to always keep my column as the first column or a 1. And then I'm going to close my parenthesis and type dot value. And I'm going to say equals I. And then I'm going to hit enter. And then I'm going to write next I. So let's look through this one more time. So let's first indent what I have between my for and my next, because these two words also go together. So I'm going to declare this variable as an integer. And I'm going to do this starting at 1 and going to 10. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the cell row of whatever I currently is, and I'm going to set the value of that cell equal to whatever I am on. So on row 1, I'll do a 1. On row 2, I'll do a 2. On row 3, I'll do a 3, etc.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So if I Alt-Tab back to Excel, now because I have a module inside of VBA, if I go up to View and go over here to Macros, and go to View Macros, I can see the name insert serial numbers listed right here. And I can name this name anything that I want, and it will appear right here in my list of macros. So if I go over here and I hit run, you can now see that row 1 gets the value of 1, row 2 gets the value of 2, row 3 gets the value of 3, etc. So let's put these side by side. And I just want to step through with you one more time so you can understand what happened. When I was 1, I went to row 1, column 1, and I set the value to 1, which is what I was at the time. And then I moved to my next I. My next I was 2. So I moved down to cell row 2, column 1, and set that value over here to 2. And then for my next I went to the cell row 3, column 1, and set that value to 3, all the way down until I got to 10. And 10 is where I want my final iteration of this code to run. Once I is greater than 10, I'm going to exit and not put any more numbers here. So that is how a for next loop works. There's another way to loop called the do until, and it's very similar to the for next here. So instead of having the for and the next I, let's take these two lines out. I'm just going to highlight them and hit backspace. And then let's click here and go do until I equals 11. And then where the next I used to be, let's type the word loop. And up here we have column 1 being changed, but let's change column 2 here. But I want you to note something here. I is going to initially be set at 0. So we are going to go from I equaling 0 to 11. But if I don't increment I somewhere in here, you are going to be stuck in an infinite loop because it's not going to ever exit because I will be equal to 0 and there's no way for I to increase. So we need to put one more line inside the do until and the loop. So I'm just going to click over here and hit enter. And then I'm going to do I equals I plus 1 so that I can keep incrementing I. Oh, and one more thing. Let's initially set I equal to 1 instead of I equaling 0, because right here, we don't have a row of 0 inside of Excel, so we'll probably get an error. So if we start I off as 1, we do have a row of 1 inside of Excel, so we shouldn't have a problem. So if we go back over here to macros and we hit run, I can see that I did get 1 through 10 in column B, which is what I was expecting to get. So those are a couple of different loops that are available to you inside of VBA. We have another loop on our blog known as the do while loop. And if you would like to get more information on that, please visit our blog. I'll include the link to our blog in the description below. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotion and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.